Okay, so this next one is a progressive combination. Now, for anyone who's done any sort of FMA or silat styles, whatever, you'd be very used to this type of motion, okay, the cross hand and or boxes, you know, because that can give you more of a reactionary gap, can give you more time to get to something rather than this hand, if this right hand is in front, for example, right? So this one is what we're using, but I don't like to always look at it as defensive, okay? I want to look at it as offensive as well, and it can often be helping you in the way of a bit of an element of surprise. So if I've gone here, the guy's real close to me, and this is in my hand because I've deemed that it's necessary and I need it for whatever reason, and I've gone that eye shot straight there. So I train to, when it's empty hand or I'm not worrying about Bob here, I'll train to hit the shoulder, as I've talked about heaps before, for that intent. Now, when I come out with this one, okay, depending on that range that I have, it could be right here, that's fine. Yeah, but I want to stretch out to the eye, get that shot, and even if it's a bait, even if he gets his hands up, that's totally cool, because that gives me options, as we've already talked about, how to get different targets and, you know, work my way around that and navigate it, you know, to X, where I need to be. Now, again, progressively, as I'm going here, I've gone 1, 2, I'm going to get on top of him. So what I mean by that is I've gone one eye shot, put one to the throat, or even the eye, if you like, whatever you want. But if that gets stuck, right, especially if I'm here and it gets stuck in tendons or shirt or a chain or whatever else is going on, right, it can and sometimes does, especially if it's serrated. If I'm going there, I want to get this on him as well. So I've gone 1, 2. There can help me get it out, as you've seen, like so. I want that uppercut and then an elbow, okay, to finish it. So let's look through that. I've got 1, 2, 3, and I train it with that intent, right? 4 with the uppercut and then the elbow as well. Now I'm making that motion big to show you because it can again help me get it out. It's weapon retention that most people who are carrying sort of don't train enough in, you know what I mean? So if this is my survival tool, I need to help it, I need to maintain it basically, so that it is that game changer or that difference maker when the odds aren't in my favor. I need to have that unfair advantage, right? So I want to maintain and protect this thing. And what I'm trying to do with this empty hand is give him that eye shot, however it lands, right? Even if it's a bitch slap, it gives me that entry, all right? 2, 3 and 4 with the elbow. So let's look at it. The shape is 1, 2, 3, 4 with the uppercut, down with the elbow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. From this angle, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's look at it the other side, because you got to train it both ways, right? So my left hand now, that's the front. This is a cross, eye shot, neck shot, put it up top, one from below, and then you've got the elbow, right? Again, this way. If you want to train the shove at the end, that's great too. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again, I'm being very, very conscious of where this is in relation to my other hand especially, and which way it's facing. So I hope you enjoyed that combination. Make sure you check out that link below, because I've actually put 6 courses together for less than the price of one. There's a ton of stuff in there, all edged weapons. Check it out because you're going to love it. Click that link below. We'll see you online.